are so handsome. Oh my god, you have such a good body. Like, in front of Hannah and the whole family, it's like so cringy. Like, okay, it's clearly awkward. And then Sienna's like, I'm gonna take grandma's boat out on the water. Or maybe it was their aunt, somebody. I don't know if someone died or it was just a family read. I don't know. Anyway, she's like, I'm going out on the water for some girl time. You wanna come? Hannah says yes. So they're out on the lake. And Sienna turns off the engine to the boat. Hannah's like, what's going on? And she's like, I don't know. I think we're out of gas or something. Or so she gets up and lifts the thing. I don't know the names of stuff on boats. She lifts this thing that's kind of covering, like, the motor in the back. And she's like, can you come hold this? And so Hannah goes to hold it. And Sienna's like, you know, my mom always wished I was you. She said, I'm not right in the head. And you just have the perfect life, don't you? The perfect house, the perfect husband, the perfect kids. You think you're so perfect. And Hannah's like, listen, I don't think I'm perfect, Sienna. Like, I don't know why you're mad at me. And anyway, Sienna pushes her into the lake. And Hannah's like, coming out of the water. And she's like, you know I can't swim. Help me, please, please. And Sienna just sits there. Lets her drown. I don't know how she explained that off when she got back to the family reunion. Because it flashed forward 7 months. And Sienna is sitting at home looking at all her past due bill notices, drinking alcohol. And calls Tony, goes, hey, Tony, how have you been doing? And he's like, well, it's been 7 months since Hannah died. I'm about as good as I could be. And she's like, oh, well, I wanted to let you know I'm moving back to town. And she lives in LA and he's in Philadelphia or whatever. So he's like, oh, where are you staying? And she goes, I haven't lined up a place yet. I have to take my real estate exam. And he's like, oh my god, come stay with us. And she's like, really, Tony, you wouldn't mind? He's like, no, of course not, your family. So he hangs up, tells the kids, and Maya's like, whatever. Like, why wouldn't everybody blame her for Anna's death? I don't get that. Like, are they not a normal family? Like, you have to, like, come on. Anyway, that's how my family would be. So she talks to herself throughout the entire movie. It was so annoying. She gets off the plane and calls and goes, hi, Tony. I'm in the cab on the way to the house. She has a really annoying voice. And she hangs up and she's like, soon you're gonna be my husband, Tony. Like, she says crap like that throughout the whole movie. So she gets there, goes upstairs, and talks to Maya. Maya's upset because the boy she wanted to go to prom with asked somebody else. So she goes up there, talks to Maya, and they get along. So the dad's like, wow, this is so great. Immediately, the housekeeper, let's call her Janet. I think it was Janet, but I didn't write it down. Janet's getting weird vibes from her because she'll tell Janet, oh, stop cooking. I'll do it. I'm doing it. I'm here. And she's like, I do it every day. And she's like, no, no, I'll do it. And then she catches Sienna upstairs in Hannah's old closet, going through her old prom keepsake box. Apparently, prom is where Hannah and Tony fell in love, and Sienna was always jealous and always had a thing for Tony. Okay. So Janet's like, what are you doing in here? And she goes, just looking for an old picture of me and Hannah. So Janet's like, this girl's crazy. So Hannah sees her drink out of her, like, tumbler in the fridge. She's like, then she starts snooping through Janice's purse and she pulls out like an AA chip and she goes, 2 years sober, not for long. And I'm like, oh god. So she puts antifreeze into Janet's drink. Janet drinks it without noticing and goes to pick up Luke, and Sienna's following, calls the cops, reports a drunk driver. They arrest her for being drunk. The toxicology comes back days later, for however long later, and she didn't have anything in her system, right? But at that point, she's already been fired by Tony. So Sienna's taking on all the responsibility, picking the kids up from school and crap like that. So she goes to pick up Maya. Now Maya, her friend, soon to be boyfriend Jake, comes to see her at school, and he's like, "What's wrong?" And she's like, "I thought you were gonna ask me to prom. That's what's wrong." And he's like, "You texted me and told me not to ask you." And she's like, "I never sent you that." So Sienna picks her up, and she tells Sienna, like, "Somebody texted him from my phone." She's like, "Oh, I know somebody who can help." But her old friends is like, "Hacker man." So they go to his house, and he goes, "If I help you, I get that date, right, Sienna?" And she's like, "Yeah, yeah." And so they sit down, and he's like, and all these numbers, numbers, numbers. And he goes, "Yeah, it looks like it was sent from this website, which changes the phone number. You can put in any phone number you want." And Maya's like, "Well, can you tell which phone number it came from?" And he goes, "Yep, there it is." And she goes, "Oh my god, that's Kate's number, like the mean girl at school who he asked to prom." And Maya goes, "Can you send me a screenshot of that?" And he goes, "Screenshot sent." And it's like, "No, you did not just text her phone a screenshot." Like, okay, it's just so stupid. Anyway, so now Maya really likes Sienna, because she helped her with that. So Maya tells Jake, and Jake then asks Maya to prom, so she's all happy. Sienna takes her prom dress shopping, and she's going through, and she finds a dress that resembles the one that Anna wore when she met Tony. So she's like daydreaming, holding it. Maya comes up and goes, "Oh my god, that's perfect." So she takes it to try it on. Now Sienna's holding it in the mirror and saying, "Oh Tony, tonight's the night we fall in love. I said yes, I said yes," like pretending she had a ring. And Anna walks out and sees her doing that. She's like, "Oh, what the heck?" Anyway, so Sienna ends up buying her that dress, and she also buys herself that dress. Now Anna is getting weird vibes. Oh, I forgot to say, Tony keeps talking about his office manager. He's a doctor named Lauren. Anna says something about, or Maya says something about, how Lauren's always flirting with her dad. So Sienna goes to the office, stalks her, sees who she is. Now the next day, she takes like 3 allergy pills and then calls Tony and being like, she's like, "Tony, I can't breathe. I think I'm having a heart attack." And he's like, "Go to the ER. And she's like, "No, I'm scared of hospitals." And he's like, "All right, come see me." So she goes in there. Sorry, my leg's falling asleep. She goes in there to see him, and he's like, "Any new medication?" She goes, "Yeah, my allergy." And he's like, "Oh my gosh, you just gotta take only one, because if you take too many, it causes heart palpitations." She's like, "Oh, silly me." Anyway, then she meets Lauren, and it's just so cringy and awkward. She ends up going, "Excuse me," and like ramming her with her shoulder, which anybody would have seen that. Lauren felt it. The doctor should have been like, "Hey, what the heck did you just do that for?" Nobody mentions it. So Tony's throwing a barbecue. He fights everybody. Lauren shows up. She's chit-chatting with him, saying, "I can't wait to go on the trip to Atlanta, because they have like a doctor's convention or something." So Sienna starts to rage, goes in the bathroom. Lauren goes to go pee and overhears her saying, "Prom night is the night that me and Tony will fall in love, and Tony will propose to me. I'm the woman of the house, not you, Lauren." And then Sienna comes out and sees that Lauren heard her. Lauren's like, "Hey, I'm just gonna head home. Tony, can I call you tomorrow? I gotta talk to you about something." He's like, "Yeah, sure." And she's like, "Yeah, I gotta go to the gym early, blah, blah, blah." Sienna shows up at the gym, pushes her down the stairs, and kills him. Tony gets the call. He's all depressed. They throw the wake at his house. Sienna's like, "Oh, Tony, I'm so sorry." And she hugs him, and she's like going like letting her eyes roll, like all romantic. And Maya sees it and like, "What the heck?" snooping around in Sienna's room, and she buys, or buys, she's snooping around and she sees the dress. She's like, why does Sienna have my prom dress? Then she sees that her real estate papers aren't even filled out, so she's not even trying to become an agent. So she goes to talk to her dad, and she talks to him with the door open, and Sienna hears, comes in, is like, hi Maya, I overheard what you said. I can tell you don't love me like I love you. She's like, I filled out my papers online because it was a lot easier, and I wasn't sure what size you were, so I bought a size 4 too, and I just haven't gotten around to returning it yet. And Maya's like, oh dang it, I feel bad. Anyway, she's still getting weird vibes. So she gets the phone number for Sienna's mom and Facebooks her. Well, she gets her name, Facebooks her, and says, please call me. Now, it's prom night. Sienna arranges for Luke to go to sleepover with a friend. So Maya comes down looking gorgeous in the dress. She goes and gets in the limo with Jake, and they're heading to prom. When they get to the prom, she gets a phone call from Sienna's mom, who tells her, oh yeah, no, Sienna was an assistant. She was never a real estate agent, because she was acting like she was one in California and was going to get be one in Pennsylvania. She's like, yeah, she's not stable. Like, she's definitely unhealthy. She's always been obsessed with Anna, and she's had a crush on Tony forever, and she's been crazy jealous. She can get violent. Be really careful. Get her out of your house. She's like, oh my god, I gotta check on my dad. Meanwhile, Sienna drugged Tony. She got all dolled up for prom. She got her hair done, everything, wearing the same dress that Maya's wearing, and decorates the entire, like, outdoor to look like prom. She wakes him up, and he's like, what is going on? And she's like, tonight's the night we're gonna fall in love. And he's like, Sienna. And she tries to kiss him, and he's like, Sienna, stop, stop. I love Hannah, blah, blah, blah. And she's like, you have no idea how much I've done for you. And he's like, what are you talking about? And anyway, it comes out that she killed Anna, right? So Tony doesn't love her. She hits him in the head with a vase, knocks him out, duct tapes him up, takes a prom picture with him, pushes him into the pool. Just as she pushes him into the pool, Maya and Jake show up. They're looking everywhere. Dad, Dad, where are you? Sienna comes in and goes, what are you doing home? She's got a knife. Maya makes it past her, and Jake's like, go, Maya, go, find your dad. And Sienna stabs Jake. Maya jumps in the pool to get her dad out of the water, pulls him to the steps, and is like, Dad, Dad. Sienna starts crying and collapses and goes, I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to kill Anna. I didn't mean to do this to you. I'm sorry. Like, how come all of a sudden she has remorse? Like, no way. She was so conniving the whole movie. Now all of a sudden she feels guilty. I don't buy that. It was just stupid. It would have been better if she was like, I'm so sorry. I tried to hurt you, and not even brought up Anna, because clearly she didn't feel bad about Anna. Anyway, it goes forward a few days. She's around.